How will you prepare for Canada Reads? I don't feel like you should answer this question.
Yeah, I don't think so. No. Because, you know, mm-hmm. you might give
we can't
away,
give away
some...
the trade secrets.
Hi, I'm Mozhdah Jamalzadah, one of the panelists for Canada Reads 2018. And this is the amazing author Sharon Bala, whose book I'm defending, The Boat People. So I have a few questions for you.
All right.
When did you know you wanted to be a writer?
Oh, I think I've always known since I was young. But knowing that you want to be something and thinking that you can be it are two different things.
Yes, I agree.
So I knew when I was quite young, I think, when I first started writing, like the first time I remember like writing in a free way on foolscap paper with a pen, I was 8. Mm. But the moment when I thought this is like an actual thing I could do and a book could be published was probably the end of 2015 when I signed with an agent.
Wow.
Yeah.
That must have been such an exciting moment.
It was so exciting.
Yeah, yeah, your dreams come
yeah,
true.
Yeah, we took a picture of like signing the contract.
Oh, that's yeah. amazing.
What was it about my book that connected with you?
Your book was probably the second book that I was presented with, and right away, like right off the bat, I was like, this is my book. I don't need to look at any other books. You know, they gave me an option and I was like, nope. I connected with it right away. After reading the summary, you know, I was like, okay, I already like this book. But when I read the first few pages, I already instantly fell in love with the characters. I mean, it was based in Vancouver. I'm from Vancouver. And just the situation with, you know, the boat and the refugees. Like, I was aware of the entire thing. Like, I was watching it on the news. And just me being a refugee myself, you know, with my family fleeing a war zone and making it to Canada and the struggles that I've seen my parents go through to get here, it definitely resonated with me, and I knew that I was, you know, I had a connection with the book. What is the strangest thing you've done to research a book?
Oh, I don't know about researching a book, but once I was writing a story where a toothbrush dropped on the floor, and I can't even remember the story now, but it was an important moment, and I was trying to describe the sound of the toothbrush dropping on the floor, and I didn't, and also the way it would look. Right. And so I literally went to my bathroom and took a toothbrush. It was mine, not my husband's, in case he's watching. And I dropped it on the floor over and over again and just watched it and listened to it, and then I, you know, wrote it down. So okay. That's the kind of... Recently, I was writing a scene with two people fighting as they're trying to get out of a bathtub, and I was trying to figure out the mechanics of how they would slip and fall onto the floor, and so I was in the bathtub by myself trying to...
Okay, that was strange.
I'm a method actor.
What is the best writing snack?
This is really disgusting.
I love food.
Oh, this is so disgusting. I don't know if this is the best snack, but I often do this because I often don't have anything in the kitchen and I'm hungry and I'm writing and I don't want to cook. So, right. Oh, this is so gross. I take a cracker and a bit of pickle, has to be sweet pickle, and then cheddar cheese.
That's it? Sweet pickle, cracker, and cheddar cheese. That's not so bad.
Delicious and disgusting. I wish you could say like a kale salad.
Yeah,
with,
I know.
You know, homemade croutons.
I don't think we're those kind of people.
No, crackers and cheese and pickle. Why did you decide to do Canada Reads?
I've been reading books since I was very little, mm-hmm. and it's the one thing that I'm really good at.
Uh-huh.
So I've actually...
The one thing.
So I've actually, like, when I was younger, I have this love for food that is, like, on another level. But I would actually spend my lunch money on novels. So you can imagine how much more I love books. And when I got the call for Canada Reads, I dropped whatever it was I was doing. And I'm like, yeah, I will be there. Because it's a huge honor for me, to be a part of, you know, Canada Reads, and to actually sit next to my favorite author and have this discussion. This is amazing. It's a dream come true for me.
Hey, I didn't know I was going to have this dream, but now I do. And it's come true too.